This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. I see all these YouTubers drinking their coffee in their videos. I think it's the new cool now. So, I'm cool? Yes, I'm cool. Wait, I don't like coffee. This is actually water. I hate coffee. It smells good, but it tastes bad. Oh yeah. By the way, sorry for my deeper voice. I have a sore throat. I don't know what's going on there. Hello guys, Jannik here for Cinecam.net and welcome to another Copycat Friday, a series where we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. As you can see, I'm standing here between the mess, our gear, and that's because we are building a platform inside our studio for a smaller studio. I know, it's Studioception. But this platform is also the reason why we are having a look at Spider-Man. We forgot the stairs, so we had to find another way to get up there. And the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man helped us with that. However, it seems that he helped a lot of YouTube channels because there are already a lot of good web shooting tutorials out there. Just like this one from Film Learning, which shows you a very well executed web shooting effect in After Effects. As we looked further, we saw that every tutorial was done in After Effects, which is completely normal. But you know us, we aren't normal. So we went for Premiere Pro. This also meant that we had to look for a different way to recreate the effect. But I'm going to let Jordi explain it further.
First try! Again, first try! Man, I'm good at this. Guys, it's gonna be really fun today because most of it are going to be practical effects. So what I'm gonna do is shoot a web up to the ceiling so that I can hang to that web, as you can see right here. This is just a simple rope. That is what you wanna do, attach a rope to the ceiling, preferably like a white, thin kind of rope like we have right here. Then to shoot this shot, make sure that you have a pretty wide angle so that you give some space for that rope to be visible in your shot. But make sure your camera sits on a tripod. That's gonna be super important because after you've taken your shot, because this is the movement that you wanna do, just grab the rope like this, then you wanna step out of the frame and make sure that the rope is also not visible in your frame anymore. In other words, we're taking an empty shot. That is what you wanna have. Those are the only two shots that you need. As for the lighting, you can pick whatever you want. There's nothing special going on with lighting.
Now that we have our shots, which was quite easy to make, it's time to swing into Premiere Pro. Yeah, I made that bad joke, sorry. But first, I want to talk about our sponsor, Storyblocks Video. This is an online stock library which we use for every project. They have high quality stock clips, templates for transitions and After Effects, and so much more. But what I really like about Storyblocks Video is their collections. Here they combine different assets with a certain genre, like this Out of World collection. To start browsing through the library of Storyblocks Video, make sure to click in the first link in the description below. Okay, now let's create the effect. The first thing you want to do is putting the original clip of your actor on the first track, then put the empty shot on top of the first one. Now disable the track output of the empty clip to reveal the original one again. Next, you can start cropping through your shot and look for the point where you grab the rope, which we hang from the ceiling. Here you can make a cut in the empty clip and delete everything right from the cut. Now you can enable the track output for the second layer again. With the empty back enabled, you can't see the original shot, so let's fix that. With the empty clip selected, go to the effects control panel and go to the opacity properties. Here you can find the pen tool, which we are going to use to create a mask. Just create a simple rectangle over your rope hanging from the ceiling. It only needs to cover the rope and nothing else. Next, give the mask a little bit more feather. After you have done this, let's start with animating. Look for the point where your actor just doesn't hit the rope. Here you can enable the animation for the mask pad. Go a few frames further in time and animate the mask so that it goes out of the screen. This will reveal the hanging rope and will give the effect that you are shooting webs out of your hand.
Hey guys, what do you think? Pretty cool, huh? our brand new platform. Yeah, probably not so exciting for you, but it is for us because that means that we can take all this mess right here and store it up there so we have a nice open studio right here. It's gonna be so good. The only thing that we forgot is to put in a stair, so there's no real way to get up there. Well, actually there is. You know, the other day I was talking to my good pal Spidey and he kind of taught me this new trick which I can use to get up there. You know, let me see if I can still do it. Let's check here. All right, let's do this.
Yep. Oh yeah, I got it. How cool is that? Ow,
this kind of hurts my hands. Is there any glove around here? Well, look at that. We got a glove, my good hands. All right, let's just grab that. Oh, pretty cool, eh? No, it is a left glove, and so I have to put it on my left hand. There we go. Now I can swing up there. Let's do this. Leroy. Now that was pretty cool, eh? But you're still wondering probably, how did we do that glove? Well, again, we're going to use some practical effects. One of the things you always run into when animating certain objects in Premiere or After Effects are physics. And you can get it right with a lot of tweaking, but you can never get it as right if you would actually let a glove fly through the air. I mean, that is real physics. So what we are doing is using some fishing wire, simple fishing wire, and we can actually get away with that because we are shooting in a wide angle shot. So that's why the fishing wire is not going to be visible. Just wrap the glove around it like so, and then Janik is going to stand in the background on that ladder. There he is. He's going to grab that fishing wire. Let me just go to him. There we go. And right now, when I'm going to do my pretty cool movement like this, the glove flies through me and I just have to grab the glove. That's it. And now back to Janik.
Thank you, Jordy, for that. But you forgot one thing. You're also going to need an empty shot. This is because we need to hide the fishing wire we are using for the glove. At some parts, it catches the light from the backlight, so it's visible in the shot. Of course, film from a tripod and let the camera roll when you're done with your acting. Then when you have your empty shot, let's go into Premiere Pro. Again, the first thing you can do is drag the shot of your actor to track number one and the empty shot to the second track. Then next, we are going to remove the fishing wire over the entire length of the shot. So create a mask on the empty layer. This only needs to be around the fishing wire on the left side. Then enable the animation for the mask pad and start animating the mask so that you don't see any wire on the left side. Now that you have a wire-free shot, we can start with the web. Of course, before we can start with the web, you're going to need one. We made ours in Photoshop with some spiderweb brushes and some shapes. So if you want, you can make your own custom web, but for the people who don't like Photoshop, you can also download ours. Just check out the download link in the description below. Okay, now search for the point where you want to let your web flinging start. We are going to let it start in Jordy's swinging motion. Now drag your web asset into the timeline and to the point to which you just determined. The first thing you can now do is shorten the web clip. Let it stop when your actor has caught the glove. After that, you can position, scale and rotate the web so that it sits on the glove. I find it easier to do this on the moment where Jordy's hand is still. This is the point where the web is going to hit the glove. For the next step, move your anchor point of the web to the center of the glove. Then you can deselect uniform scale, which we are doing so that we can stretch the web a little bit. Otherwise, it would be too short and wouldn't reach my hand. Now that the web is in place, let's start animating it. Enable the animation for the position, both scale properties and the rotation. But because we aligned the web in the middle of the clip, we need to first animate it back to the beginning and then to the end. So move frame by frame back to the beginning and adjust your web. The end of the web should always be following your hand. Now do the same towards the end, but here also let the web follow the glove. Now you should already have a web that follows your hand, but it doesn't shoot yet, so let's fix that. Go into the effects control panel and inside the opacity property, take the pen tool. On the same point where you aligned your web, draw a rectangle mask. Enable the animation for the mask path and go back to the beginning of the web clip. Here you can drag the right side of the mask to the left so that you only have a small part of the web visible. Now keep animating and revealing the web to the point in the middle. Beyond this point, you can now animate the left side of the mask so that it never goes further than your hand. We are almost there, guys, so keep with me. Next, duplicate the layer of your actor and place it above everything. Make it as long as a web clip and create a mask around the web flinging hand. Again, enable the animations for the mask and let the mask follow the actor's hand. this can be quite rough as there will be a lot of motion blur. Okay, you are already shooting webs from your hand, but let's give it some more motion. Search for the turbulent displays effect in the effects library and drag it to your web clip. In the effects control panel, decrease the size a little. You can also animate the evolution to give the web some more wiggle while it's being shot towards the glove. Now the last details are going to be blending and motion blur. First set the blending mode in the opacity property to lighten and decrease the opacity a little. As last, search for the directional blur in the effects library and drag that to the web clip. Set the direction to around 70 degrees and the blur length to around 30. Animate the blur length so that there's no motion blur in the middle, only in the beginning and in the end. Now look at that. Now you are a real Spider-Man, ready to save your Mary Jane. And that was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative. I really got a radio voice now. Welcome to KDB Radio, the radio where funk meets soul. I should work for the radio. I should work for the radio. Batman! Batman!